Welcome to videos on data converters. In this video we shall see the pipeline ADC. So assume that this is the input voltage, input analog voltage which is to be converted and which we are supposed to digitize. So we know that in the previous videos using sub-ranging converters, so we can effectively reduce the number of comparators required in a flash ADC. So we have this sample and hold circuit, that's the coarse flash ADC, and which will generate the first part of the digital output, and its residue is obtained by comparing that with the DAC output and the original input. That is amplified by a residue amplifier, and then we'll get the remaining bits using the fine flash ADC. Here, I think that at time phi 1, so at phi 1 time, input signal is sampled and held till coarse ADC and fine ADCs are complete their conversion process. Assume that you can see we have given a time t is equal to phi 1. At time t is equal to phi 1, the input data from VI is been sampled and it is held using this sample and hold circuit, and it is given to first coarse flash ADC. Coarse flash ADC will take some time and it will convert the analog to digital, that is compared here, and a difference is obtained using the subtractor, and there is a RA amplifier giving the output, and later this fine flash ADC will give the output. Meaning this coarse flash ADC has to wait till this fine flash ADC gives the output. Unless this fine flash ADC gives the input, the coarse flash ADC is not taking the next input for its process. Now, in order to get the next input, the coarse flash ADC has to wait till the fine flash ADC completes its process. Now here you can see that's what I have written. The coarse ADC has to unnecessarily wait, has to wait till the fine ADC completes the conversion, the process to accept the next input for conversion. So I will be accepting the next input only after the fine flash ADC completes the entire conversion process. Now this coarse flash ADC has to simply wait even though it has completed its operation. So this is a waste of time. So the entire conversion time will be reduced, and we cannot sample many number of data within a given time. So that's what is given here. So I am sampling the input at T1, and I will sample the next input only after the fine flash ADC gives its output. Unless that point I cannot access, because this is the conversion time. You can see this time is too much of a time. During this time the input has changed a lot. So we will not be getting any information about the changes in the output voltage during this period, because here we are unnecessarily waiting. The coarse ADC has to wait until the flash ADC completes, even though the coarse ADC has completed its part of the conversion. Using pipelined ADCs, it is possible to effectively utilize the ADCs to increase the throughput of ADCs. Now, in this pipelined ADC, the advantage is that, so this waiting of the coarse flash ADC when your fine flash ADC is converting, that will be minimized. So that will be nullified. So that we're going to have a greater throughput of ADCs. That is, number of samples that can be obtained will be more. Number of samples, okay, we have this only 4 samples. Instead of 4, we can have actually 8 samples within the given time. So hence ADC can produce more digital outputs in the given time of T1 to T4. We can suppose if it was not a pipeline, we would have got only 4 digital outputs. Suppose if I use a pipelined ADC, I can able to get within the same time from T1 to T4. Within this time, I can able to get 8 different samples, so that the throughput of ADC is increased. Let us see how does a pipelined ADC works. So, you know, this is stages of this pipelined ADC, stage 1, stage 2, stage J and stage N. So each stage consists of a sample hold circuit, a k-bit ADC and a k-bit DAC, and there's a subtractor and a residue amplifier. So this is like our sub-ranging ADC, where we have instead of fine ADC, we'll have only these coarse ADCs along with the DAC, a subtractor and a residue amplifier repeated for n number of stages. We shall see how does this pipelined ADC performs. So this pipelined ADC breaks down the conversion task into a sequence of n serial subtasks, and use of sample and hold circuit between the stages will isolate and allow the individual subtask to proceed. So because this will going to hold the previous value, so this will not whatever changes that happens in the previous will not be affected, because you are holding the previous value in this particular sample and hold circuit. We'll see the working of this in the coming slide. Now this is the block diagram of pipelined ADC. You can see now the first stage samples VI, digitizes k bits and uses a DAC subtractor RA circuit to create a residue for the next stage in the pipeline. So assume that this is your first stage. At time t is equal to t1, you have taken the input voltage, you have digitized it by k number of bits, and that is given to this DAC, and then DAC has found out, the subtractor has just found out the difference, and this RA amplifier has produced the residue of it. So now this residue is available for the next stage of the pipeline ADC. The next stage samples the incoming residue and performs a similar sequence of operation while the previous stage begins processing the next sample. Now in the previous case of subranging, actually the coarse was supposed to wait till the fine completes its process. Now it is not so. So once the RA, that is residue, is available over here, this residue is passed on to next stage. Once this is passed on to next stage, now this stage is ready to accept the new sample. So that's the biggest advantage. So here it is not at all waiting for the next stage to complete the process. So as soon as it is completed the operation, when it is given to the next stage, now it is ready to accept the previous stage. Now it is not waiting whether the next stage has completed the process. The next stage is doing its work. Now this will start a new process with the new input voltage. Now this is how it works. Now you can see now at t is equal to t1, input A is fed to ADC1. So ADC1 has started the process. This is first stage. Next, at t is equal to t2, input is given to, now input is B. The ADC1 converts that B input, whereas ADC2 will convert the residue of A. So by the time t2, this first stage has already completed the conversion, it has generated the residue. At time t is equal to t2, the ADC1 is ready to accept the second sample, that is B, whereas the second stage is taking the residue of the first sample, that is A here. Let us see what happens in t3. So in t3, the input is C, that is been accepted by ADC1. Now it will start conversion for C. Whereas ADC2 will take the residue of sample B, and ADC3 will take the residue of A. So because this residue of A was there in ADC2, that has passed on to ADC3. Now ADC2 will take the previous ADC output here. This B has been passed here, and this ADC1 is taking the new sample. Likewise, now in the fourth, V in is taking D. V in is taking, sorry, this ADC1 is taking input D sample, whereas second ADC is taking the C sample, the residue of C sample. ADC3 is taking the B sample, residue of B sample, and ADC4 is processing the residue of the first sample, that is A. Likewise, you can see each time whenever you sample, So its residue is passed on to the next subsequent stage. So this is how all the process, all the converters will be working at a time. It will be processing the residue from the previous sample. The ability of various stages to operate concurrently makes the conversion rate depend on the speed of only one stage, usually the first stage. Now you can see what happens is the first stage, once it samples, now it will give the residue to the next stage. Now when you accept the next sample, the next sample can be immediately accepted once the first stage completes its process and give it to the next stage. So here in the previous case we might have seen that, so in the subranging we were supposed to wait till this, so you can see the time was this much, because T2 you can sample only after your the fine ADC has completed the process. But in case of pipelined it is not so. It can now easily accept this one second sample, because the first stage has completed its process of conversion and it has generated the residue and it has passed on to the next stage. Next, pipeline structure are used in a variety of formats, including the case k is equal to 1. So meaning to say, the first stage can be of only 1 bit. So which is result in a now pipeline structure, we can have varieties of possibilities. The first stage can be only of 1 bit, and next stage can be of different stages, but we should have n number of stages so that all those n number of stages will give the final output. We'll just take up an example and try to identify how does pipeline ADC number of bits will be selected. So after first stage ADC will accept, after the first stage ADC will accept the next input immediately, the first stage ADC will accept the next input immediately after it has transferred the residue of the present input to the second stage. So this ADC1 can accept the next input as soon as it has passed down the residue to the second stage. Likewise, every stage will pass on its residue to the next stage and will accept the input residue from the previous stage. Now this is what a pipelined ADC will do. It will process the data, it will pass on to the next stage. Once it has passed on, now it can take the next input, which is actually the residue from a previous stage. That is, at any given time all the ADCs will be processing one or the other input. So the first one will take the actual sample, the subsequent ADCs will be working on the residue from the previous stage. Now this is how this first stage takes the input, the second stage takes the residue from this, third stage takes the residue from this. So all these will be processing simultaneously one or the other input. Now number of stages include the total bit size of the output and bit size of the individual ADC stage. So assume that you have n is equal to 10 bits. So one of the possible combination is could be, we can have the first bit as 1 bit and subsequent 3 bits as 3 bit each. So you can see it is 3 bit, 3 bit, 3 bit. The first one is 1 bit. So there are 4 stages. The first stage is 1 bit, second is 3 bits, 3 bits and 3 bits. So this is one of the possible way for implementing a 10 bit pipelined ADC. The digital equivalent of the first analog value sampled during T1 will be available after the end of T4. So it takes 4 clock pulses to get the output of the first sampled value. Now the digital equivalent of the second analog value sampled during T2, this is actually T2. So this is, you can see the value that is sampled during T1, that is the first sample, will be available after the end of 4 clock pulses, whereas the one that is sampled, second sample which is sampled at T2, will be available after T5. So meaning every one cycle will going to be, after every one bit, after T4 we'll get first sample, After T5 will get second sample, after T6 will get third sample. Likewise, there is no wastage of time.